see you. Happy birthday, mate.
Thank you, cheers.
But how do you feel about that win over Sweden now? Watching from afar, seeing how comfortable the team was, how composed the team was, there weren't even any major celebrations at the end of the win against Colombia. Does that feel that the confidence is growing? Is that what we read into that?
We haven't won anything yet, so there's no point in celebrating. Obviously, it was nice to get a victory, and I think the celebrations were muted, just obviously because you know there's still big games to come up. So you know, there's a lot to play for. You know, I've said all along that the team spirit that we've got here has been fantastic, and I think you see the way that we celebrate after the game. We get ourselves back to the hotel, recover, prepare in the right way, and go for the next game.
Ashley, are we going to win this World Cup?
I think we've got a great chance. We've put ourselves in a great position to go on to win it. I said before the start of the tournament that you know, we're not going out there to not go and win the World Cup. So you know, I think, like I said, we've put ourselves in a great position.
Ashley, hi, Steve Scott from ITV. Croatia have obviously gone through the extra time of penalties twice. Can you give us an idea of how it tests you emotionally and physically to go to extra time?
I think especially physically, it's demanding on the body. You know, to go 120 minutes, and then obviously you've got to fly back as well to base. So you know, we fell down. They've done that twice now. So you know, it could play a major advantage. But you know, like I say, we know it's going to be a tough game, and we've got to be mentally and physically prepared for what they bring throw at us.
You were one of the few to have been born in 1990, 28 years ago. I wonder if you've ever spoken to any of the guys who played in that match about their experience and about the regrets they had of not winning it.
And I'm old, but I'm not that old, so I've not spoken to any of them since. But and like I say, we're concentrating on us, what's going on now, not what's happening in the past. We've got to look forward to the future. Like I say, we've got a massive game coming up on Wednesday, so everybody's just looking forward to that now.
Ash Damrow, BBC. How do you prepare for what is surely the biggest game of your life? I mean, not for 28 years as a team representing this country, but in the semi-final, you're in a place very few thought you'd get to. How are you feeling? How are you preparing for any different interusion?
No, of course not. We're going to prepare in the same way we prepared for every other game that we've had out here. We said, the players have said, the staff said that you know we're creating our own stories. And you know, like I say, 28 years since we've gone to a semi-final, and you know, I don't think there's any player that was in that dressing room that's in this squad that would have told you that we're not confident that we were going to get there, and we're not saying that we've never been confident to get to the final. So you know, I think that's all been said by yourselves in the press that you know we weren't going to get there. But you know, for us inside that squad and the staff surrounding us, we've got that belief that you know, that great team spirit, confidence to go as far as we want, and like I say, we're looking to complete the journey in the right way and hopefully win the World Cup.
What would it mean for you personally if you could become a World Cup finalist? And it feels surreal almost talking in those terms. What would it mean to you as a footballer to reach the pinnacle the game has to offer?
Yeah, I think it's one of them things as a kid, where you dream of playing the World Cup and you know, you dream of winning the World Cup. You know, we're not going to get too ahead of ourselves and get carried away. Everybody's feet are on the ground and everybody's putting in the right way. Like I said, we're just going to prepare in the same way that we have done for every other game. It's another game that we've got coming up, and that's how we're going to see it.
Carrie Brown,
Beansport.
Actually, coming into this World Cup, it's a question mark whether you would start Kieran Trippier as well, building his reputation in the 6 months leading up to this World Cup. Why have you done so well with Perry?
I think it's down to the manager giving us the confidence to go out there and play. You know, it's not just the two of us that you've mentioned. It's there's 11 players that have come on the pitch, but it's a squad game as well. Everybody in the squad is pulling each other. Everybody's keeping each other on their toes, and the competition for place is, you know, incredible. It's unbelievable. The training every day is, you know, at high intensity. Everybody's giving 100%, and you know, when you've got every player wanted to try and get in that starting 11. You know, everybody's here on their own merit. They've done fantastic well to get in the squad, and everybody's got something to give.
Does this feel real, and do you even really want to entertain that you're in a semi-final, or are you quite enjoying coming back to sleeping Rapino and just staying focused?
That's what you've got to do. You've got to just stay focused. I've said you've said that togetherness that we've got has been unbelievable since the time I got back in the squad. And I think the fans back home are getting more and more excited. Obviously, we're excited, but we know we've got a job in hand and we've got a tough game coming up.
Actually, Steve from AP, you're obviously one of the set-piece takers for, well, one of the set-piece takers for England. Can you give us an insight into sort of meticulous preparation you're doing on set pieces and how sort of important you think it'll be in the game on Wednesday?
I think set pieces have been a massive thing for us and for other teams as well throughout the whole of the World Cup. I'm not sure how many goals have been scored from set pieces, but you know, obviously we work on attacking and defending, and you know, they're vitally important to us, which you've seen. They've worked in our favour, so I'm sure we're going to carry on working on them, but you know, I can't give too much detail there.
Is it more than you usually do when you go to United or previous teams you've done? Is that one of the main things you've been doing?
It's not one of the main things, but it's an important thing to do, obviously. Especially attacking, you see the boys that, you know, get in the box, they're willing to, especially H, put his head through a brick wall. Everybody wants to go and score. Everybody wants to win, and you know, if you've got people that can put the ball in the box and you've got people that want to go and head it, then you know, it's just going to go and get the goals.
Hi, it's Lemmy Angel Moreno from the Spanish news agency EFE. I would like to know your opinion about Croatia and about Luka Modric.
Well, Croatia as a whole are a very good team. They're not in a semi-final for no reason. So obviously we've got to be prepared for them. You know, they've got the likes of Luka Modric and the team, which is a fantastic player, but they've got players around the squad that are going to be difficult runners. You know, we can't concentrate too much on them. We've got to concentrate on ourselves, and that's exactly what we'll be doing going into the game.
Hi, actually, Thiago Arantes, Rádio Sagres from Brazil. There's been a lot of debate about the influence of coaches in the style of play that England is showing in this World Cup. Paul Scholes himself told that he sees some things of Pep Guardiola in this team. There are lots of Tottenham players, which means that Pochettino might have some influence. Do you see the influence? Do you feel this influence? And what coaches and styles of play do you think are present in this team?
I think the coaches and style of play are from the manager here. You know, obviously, everybody plays at their clubs in a different way, but you know, since we've been out together, it's a place where every player wants to be on the ball, and no one's scared to receive the ball, and you know, whether it's at the back or if it's at the front. It's a team, everybody likes to play with the ball. There's no long balls, it's, you know, short passing and moving. I think that's what's set us up in every game, that we've been able to pass teams off the pitch and create chances, and that's exactly what we'll be looking to do when we take to the pitch on Wednesday again.
Ashley, Mark Hockley, SPN. You've been away with England before at tournaments, I think in Poland, and successful. So what have you got right this time, the manager of the FA, in terms of keeping you all happy and keeping you all focused and together?
I think, you know, not just the players in the squad and the staff, that you see, I think it's the staff behind the scenes as well, making the hotel feel like you're at home, pictures of families in the rooms, you know, things they're to do in the hotel. You know, I think if you said to any player that they was going to be together for 7 weeks, and a lot of them talked about being bored, but you know, it's not felt like that. It's felt like a good holiday we've been on, and we're enjoying every moment of it. There's no boredom at all. You know, everybody gets on well off the pitch. I think if you've got that off the pitch, it seems really togetherness. You take it onto the pitch, and I think, you know, the fans, you know, staff, players, everybody can see how well everybody's put together.
Question here, please. Mark, can I just do, please?
Russian newspaper Sport Express, actually Croatian defender Demogavida after knocking Russia out of the World Cup shouted glory to Ukraine, and now a number of Russian fans saying they will support England in the semifinals. What's your attitude to that fact? Thank you.
That's something new. I've not heard that. It's always nice to have fans from all over the country supporting us. You know, like I said, we've got an important game coming up. The more fans we have, the better, and you know, hopefully we can go and win the game.
Hi, actually, Matt Dingle, said from the Times. A lot has been said that it's a collective effort that England have put in, but if I can put you on the spot, do you pick one player who you think particularly has stood out for you, raised their game, deserve to be MVP, so far?
No, you can't put me on the spot. Like I said, it's a squad game. I wouldn't pick out one player. I don't think any player in the squad will pick out one player. Everybody from the ones that started, the ones on the bench, have done fantastically well, pushing each other in training day in, day out, and getting the right results in the game. I think everybody's, if I give it MVP, it'd be every single player that's in the squad.